fire bosses are demanding an urgent inquiry after broken equipment left crews unable to battle a blaze that gutted a home in Melbourne's west. It's the final straw for their union, which claims our fleet of trucks is so run down, lives are being put at risk.
Roaring flames lit up Truganina late last night. But firefighters could do nothing to help.
Is everyone safe?
Their truck had plenty of water, but a broken pump meant they had no way to use it.
Trying approximately 7 to 8 times to try to engage the pump, having the truck stall, was unable to supply water.
We could have been very well talking about a fatality tonight.
That forced a firefighter to risk his own life, going in to save the resident inside without a working hose line.
The firefighter had no lifeline. There was no water supply. And that meant he was at risk, as well as that member of the public.
Firefighters have been complaining for months about the dire state of Victoria's fire truck fleet. For them, this was the last straw.
There are 60 fire trucks that are currently past their use-by date. On a daily basis, they break down.
In December, 2 firefighters were injured in a deadly factory blaze, where a 20-year-old tanker malfunctioned.
We have built new fire stations, we have invested in new trucks, and this will be something that the government will continue to talk to our firefighters about.
The government has bought 12 new trucks, but the union says that won't cover for the 60 that are out of date.
That's not good enough, is it?
And Geordie Wright, firefighters want more action from the government.
Mitch, the union says the water pumper used in last night's fire has had 27 logged reports of malfunctions over the past 2 months, and it's not the only one. The UFU is now calling for an immediate inquiry into Victoria's firefighting resources, adding dozens of trucks should be taken off the road until they meet the standard to keep the community safe. Mitch.
Geordie Wright at West Melbourne, thank you.